There's a quote of Philip K. Dong that says, "There exists, for everyone, a sentence, a series of words, that has the power to destroy you. Which sentence is it for you?" Not that it destroys me, but it 180s my mood. When people make fun of the way I laugh, which is heartfelt and genuine and a big belly laugh, it's ridiculous and makes 90% of people laugh with me, but there's 10% of people who look at me like I'm insane, and then I can never laugh around them again. The only ones that love you are required to. Your cancer has returned. I barely made it through chemo and radiation last time. I think he'll be letting it take me if it comes back. I hope you will be okay. So I was looking through your browser history. Let me look through your Reddit history. I am not sure what single quote has the power to destroy me, but these two are the closest. I could never love you. After a 2-year relationship with someone, I wish I never had you. My mother. My ex-husband told my oldest child that he wished he had never been born. My son was about 8 years old then. We're now divorced. My son is 20, and they have a very limited relationship. I will never forget my child's heartbreak at that moment, ever. Well, several sentences after I found out that my best friend of 15 years is a snake. They include "you don't matter to anyone or anything around you, so it's better that you don't keep denying it. You're useless and a pain and no one's saying this, but really, you should have jumped that afternoon." That is absolutely awful. I am so sorry, though I know that doesn't help you much. "We did everything we could, and I'm sorry for your loss. The paramedics after my mom took a nap on the couch and never woke up. It's been 7 months and 3 days and I'm still destroyed and it plays over and over in my head. As a paramedic, this is the hardest thing I have to do. I can handle trauma and gore, but telling a family we are stopping, it crushes me. I'm sorry for your loss. I can't imagine a world without my mom. You make me happy, but being with you is making me miserable. Mental illness is insidious. If you think you might suffer from something that's negatively affecting your friendships or relationships, please talk with a therapist or a psychiatrist before it's too late. Sometimes, even after getting treatment, the damage is already done. Trust is earned, but with a lot of people it can only be earned once. My girlfriend suffers from mental issues. Sometimes, that exact sentence is what goes through my brain. I love her more than anything, but it's hard sometimes. You're not the daughter that I wanted. Cut deep, still does. Well, you're not the mother I wanted, but here we are. I used to be so proud of you. You used to be so beautiful, my mum. I'm sorry, I didn't quite get that. I said, one large pan pizza with pepperoni and black olives. I don't love you anymore. We need to talk. My dad used those words and it was followed by, there's dinner for you in the microwave. He was unaware of the horror of these words. I'm going to cut you into little pieces and put you in a bag then kill myself. My mom, circa 3 hours ago. I remember the moment. I was in the hospital. It was my 29th birthday. My girlfriend and I had just been hit by a drunk driver. I was getting glass removed from the laceration in my arm. I was confused, but calm. The surgeon stitched my wounds. My father walked in the room. I had never seen him cry before. He looked at me and broke down. I'm so sorry, she didn't make it. I am so sorry. Nobody actually likes you. We all just pretend to, but you're actually super annoying. I legit told my friends, how the frick do you put up with me? I don't even like me. They didn't like that. And later when one of them came over and we discussed the most annoying parts of our common friends, I asked what he thinks is my biggest flaw or most annoying thing I do. And he told me that I keep dragging myself down. I have good friends. Not many, but good ones. We were only your friend because you wouldn't take the hint. It was an offhand comment my mother made while we were arguing about something or other. You're such a burden. Her English isn't great, and it was the first time I'd ever heard her say the word, or even suggest she knew what it meant. We still don't speak much. Yes, I got maybe your dad would have loved you if you'd been born a boy. My dad was cruel, but deep down he loved me despite himself. My mom was projecting. I figured out she'd never loved me. Not for a moment. She hates everyone, so I'm not special. Made it a little easier to digest. I'm disappointed in you. I am very proud of you because you wrote in this post. No one wants you here. Anyone can say it. And no matter how much progress I've made, it always rings true. My best friend. Do you have a best friend? Dot. I thought I did. Stop talking. That hurts deeply because I love talking. What if every relationship you've ever been in is somebody slowly figuring out they didn't like you as much as they hoped they would? James A. Acaster ironically said during his stand-up routine, which otherwise was hilarious. Relationships are like houseplants. Some people manage to get them to grow and thrive. I just try to get them to die as slowly as possible. Your tumor from 3 years ago has returned. Quetzalcoatl, I know your Reddit account is Quetzalcoatl. You've just revealed your Reddit name to everybody here. Fool. Mwahahahaha. Your mother has passed. I was raised by a single mother for most of my life before she remarried. But even then, it's always been me and her against the world. Most of who I am is because of her. I dread the day that she passes on to the next world. I know for a fact that sentence will destroy me. Not forever, but it will destroy a part of who I am. Along same lines. But it wasn't even a sentence. My father passed away suddenly and my wife took the phone call. The look she gave me when she had to tell me did more damage than the words that followed. Single most heartbreaking moment of my life. This thread is making me emotional. You look like you're going to spend your life having one epiphany after another, always thinking you've finally figured out what's holding you back, and how you can finally be productive and creative and turn your life around. But nothing will ever change. That cycle of mediocrity isn't due to some obstacle. It's who you are. The thing standing in the way of your dreams is that the person having them is you. Unexpected item in the bagging area. Remove this item before continuing. They know. Spoken by the right person. You're just like your dad. This, but my mother. It would utterly destroy me if someone truly meant it. Me and my female friend are growing apart right now and I'm having a hard time accepting it, though I haven't brought it up. So MNE would be, I can't respond and I'm only pretending to be busy. Can you PLS stop texting me? We aren't like that anymore. Whatever we had, it gone. So just go. TCH, like I'm gonna tell you my weakness. See, this is genius, because that is the sentence that would destroy you, but everybody will just think you are being defensive. What is wrong with you? This crushes me every time I remember it. It's what I shouted at my 4-year-old son after some random thing he did, and it's my most shameful memory. He burst into tears and I worry every day that somehow it's imprinted into his memory and irrevocably altered his personality. I love him to so much, but somehow my brain is just terrible with people. Even the people I love the most. I wish I knew what was wrong with me. Being a parent doesn't make you perfect. You're still human. You'll still frick up. I'm sure your son doesn't dwell on it like you do. Don't be so hard on yourself. I don't want to be friends with you anymore. I'm broken to pieces. You're not good enough. You are the weakest link. Goodbye. I don't know if I've ever loved anyone. From my fiancé, who had proposed to me a year prior. Spoiler alert, we didn't get married. It did destroy me. I had initiated the conversation about our impending wedding because I was concerned that we weren't working well as a team. I wanted a real family life. I'm still not sure what he wanted, really. I know he is a good person. But when things got tough, I wanted to be able to turn toward my partner for comfort and help and strength so that we could work together to solve whatever we were up against. He wouldn't try counseling. He wouldn't talk to me, wouldn't tell me what was wrong. Said that I was selfish for wanting us to have more similar work schedules. Said that it was weird for me to want us to have more intimacy and sex when we weren't trying to conceive. Insisted it was fine that we only saw each other 5 hours or so per week. I worked weekdays during the day. He worked mostly Saturday, Wednesday nights. It was hard. I loved him. I wanted more. He didn't. We slept in separate rooms at night and called off our engagement shortly thereafter. We shared our small house in separate bedrooms for 6 months after that while he made arrangements to move out of state. It was sad. It was a grieving period. But from destruction comes the opportunity for renewal. I lived alone for a while. Got to know myself again. Made a new routine. Started over. Several months later I reconnected with someone really special. He changed my life. We're married now. I wonder what would have happened if I hadn't had that conversation with my ex. Would we have gotten married, had kids, been miserable, been okay with settling for each other? Could we have worked through things together and been genuinely happy? I don't know. I don't really need to know. My husband is the person I'm supposed to be with. He's my person. And I know I am his. He's my everything. I wake up in the morning so grateful for the gift of real, true love in my life. And I never would have gotten to this place if it weren't for the worst thing that ever happened to me. Only dumb people get less than A's. My father to me as a child. Routinely hearing things like this from him really screwed up my confidence and self-worth, on top of feeling like it's responsible for my abnormally extreme fear of failure. If I am not automatically good at something new, the overwhelming sense that it's because I am dumb makes me quit quickly. If someone even jokingly calls me dumb or stupid, I shut down internally and find the quickest escape from the situation. It really hits home when I'll be talking to someone or telling a story, and the person doesn't even notice if I stop speaking mid-sentence. I feel like this is attributes to why I've always been antisocial and horrible with relationships. I don't even like cookies that much. I love baking and particularly enjoy making over-the-top cookies. They bring so much joy when I bring them into work or take them to parties. I was in a long-distance relationship, so whenever we'd visit I'd bake something new and special. If he was having a bad day I'd overnight him a carefully packaged box of homemade cookies. When we were breaking up, nothing nasty, just realizing neither of us ever wanted to leave our respective cities, he told me he didn't even really like cookies. I spent so many hours looking up recipes, buying ingredients, prepping, baking, and that was what I got. When he tried to get me back later, haha nope. I need a man that appreciates my cookies. For me, it wasn't a sentence, but the lack of one. There was one person who brought some light in my everyday life, and she just stopped responding. Without any clue what I did wrong, or what went wrong in her life, or anything. Being left behind without a single sentence of reason why crushed me more than anything before. What the frick is oatmeal? I don't fear these words but rather the one who speaks and means them. You needed worthy opponents. Everyone in the family talks about how you need to get your crap together but we're all afraid that if we say something about it to you, you'll have another one of your little breakdowns. My mom, circa 2015. Still haven't gotten my crap together. Still have severe depression. The words my mom told me after our last talk. Note, we are no longer on speaking terms and I just wish we could patch things up. You have been nothing but a pain for everyone. You can't do anything right. You'll remain stupid and alone forever. I don't want to see you ever. I need a hug. Hugs sent to you. I hope the effect of the sentence vanish over time and you to get better. We were never your friend. You have been visited by the romantic doggo. Comment love is magic so you never fall in the friend zone. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Or don't. Either way, have a great day you magnificent people.